It's not your first thought that counts under stress. Psychologists have found what really drives your reaction is your second thought. They call it arousal reappraisal. Arousal reappraisal. Here's the cool thing about that. If you go, most people go around that corner and they go, oh no, and they see that moose. Now, I thought, oh gosh, that customer, oh my gosh, this is going to be terrible. Or man, if the bank changes hands, what's going to happen to me? And it's going to, I might lose my job, and then my wife's going to divorce me, and then I'm on the street. And you're thinking in negative directions when the stress hits, if you allow yourself to do what psychologists call going to a threat orientation. People who struggle under stress, their second thought is threat, what may or may not happen. And that is the struggler mentality. Okay? Because here's the deal. Whenever you go, oh no, the moose, your second thought is, my gosh, what could happen here? Then all of a sudden your body and brain start to go into protective mode, close up mode. All the blood in your body gets pooled right here. That means in case you got cut, you wouldn't bleed out quite as quickly. Blood is pulled from your brain. You want less blood in your brain when you're under stress. No, thank you. No, you don't, because it slows your thinking speed. It even causes your peripheral vision to start closing in. Basically, your brain and your body shut down because you went into a threat orientation. Now, let me flip it for you. Psychologists say that if you look at that threat, and instead of thinking what may happen, you think, what can I do? They call that a threat. They call that a challenge orientation. And that triggers, cues an entirely different physical and psychological reaction. The blood isn't pulled in, it's perfused out. Blood is pushed into your brain. Your thinking speed picks up. You're able to deal with stress in an energetic and calm way because of something you have 100% control over, your second thought. Like I said, psychologists call it arousal reappraisal. I call it second thought thinking. Leaders, people who thrive under stress, are better at second thought thinking. People who are great leaders and influencers are better in their communication at helping others go from threat to challenge-based thinking. Not what may happen, what can we do here? And when you do that, blood perfuses up in your brain, your thinking speed picks up, even your peripheral vision widens. You're in a great state to handle stress because of your second thought. Now, let me ask you, when someone comes to you at work with a problem, you can tell they're stressed out. Do you think they're thinking about what they can do for the situation or what may happen because of the situation? 99% of the time, people, your customers, your coworkers, your loved ones, when they're stressed out, they're in this threat mode. And if you can redirect them from threat to challenge, you can change the energy in their body, in their brain, and change the energy in the room if you're able to do that. And I'm going to help you do that.